Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. I'm assuming you're probably looking at motorhomes, otherwise you wouldn't be taking a look and spending the time to let me show you a coach here. So I'm grateful that you're giving me an opportunity to show you a motorhome. My name's Jim Beckler, and I'd like to show you a 31W Fleetwood Bounder. This is a 2002 model, really nice little layout. Maybe you're looking for a smaller motorhome, you know, kind of in that mid-range, I guess, would be probably a little more appropriate. This would be a nice little motorhome. It's built on a Ford chassis, has a V10 engine in it, so it's got plenty of power to get you down the road, and certainly enough power to pull a nice little boat or a car behind it. As we walk around the motorhome, you can see on this side, let's have a nice slide out over here with an awning that covers it to help keep the debris from building up on top of your slide out. I like the fact that the storage compartments come out on this too. So when your slide comes out, your storage comes out as well. Nice thing about that is you don't have to crawl underneath there to get to your stuff when the slide's out. This one has your generator and your workstation right here all in one spot. Nice size generator, 5500 on end, so you got plenty of power for your run your generator. This is actually on 30 amp service, so your power cords here, all your hookups for your sewer, fresh water, even has a little black tank flush, which makes it nice. You can hook up a fresh water hose to that and put some pressure to it, help keep your black tank cleaned out. We can look around to the back of the motorhome. You can see you have good access to get up on top if you need to go up for any service issues. It's all set up to tow. You can see it's got a nice little tow hitch. Another slide out over on this side of the motorhome with an awning. So it's a double slide coach. Again, 31W is the model number. Got good storage, large patio awning. See, it has an encased awning. Everything's enclosed inside of that encasement, so the material of your awning isn't exposed to the weather. It makes it nice and seem to hold up a much better. Nice size storage compartments. You can see your fresh water tanks back underneath there, so that's going to be out of the weather. Really, these motorhomes are nice for all-season travel. If you like to get out, even when the colder weather hits, you can be comfortable and not worry about having to have everything freeze up on you. So up front here, you've got nice seating. One of the things I really like about a Class A motorhome is the visibility too. When you're sitting and going down the road, you have good visibility. You can take in the views. These seats, front seats, will swivel around too, so you can actually use these as part of your furniture in your main living area here. This is equipped with a leveling jack, so it has a leveling system. And you can see up in front here, you've got your gen start, and you can check your holding tanks and see what kind of usage you have in your black and your gray tanks as well. Nice little swivel rocker, a little chair up front here. This one has the main slide is rather large. You can see it's pretty deep, goes back almost 3 feet with a little shelf behind the sofa. So it's got a nice little sofa in it with looks like it has hide-a-bed capability, so you can make this into a bed. Got more than one sleeper. I see there's looks like your original, all the original books that came with it. Good amount of storage in the slide up above. Lots of windows too. That really makes it nice. You have lots of natural light back in here. You really notice that on a day like this, even though we have a motorhome right next to it, it still you got a lot of light coming in. It'd even be better if we didn't have these stacked in the way we do. But you've got a nice size dinette booth here. that we'll make into a sleeper also, with storage down below here underneath. Really adds a lot to the livability. That's kind of what we talked about before, the fact that it's, you know, a 31 model, but so it's, you know, not a long motorhome, but with the slide outs, it really opens this up. And we'll see in the bedroom area, having that slide back there really makes a difference too. Kitchen area has good amount of counter space, the double sinks, has sink covers, even has a cover over the stove to give you a little bit more counter space. Good amount of storage in the kitchen area. Nice drawers, bigger, larger oven. Looks like that's the larger of the two ovens that they put in motorhomes. This is a 22 inch with nice three burner cook stove. Stove top, microwave oven. The refrigerator's gas electric, so this will operate off of either or. If you dry camp a lot, you can run that off the gas side. If you're plugged in somewhere at a park, you can run it off the electric element. Apparently it has a charging system for your batteries. Must have a solar system up on top. I like the fact it's got a nice high-powered fan right here in the galley area too. So if you're in here working, you can have that fan. It moves a lot of air, keeps everything ventilated very well even without your air conditioning on. You can move a lot of air. The air conditioning is ducted, has two air conditioners. There's one here and one forward, but you can see there's ductwork all the way throughout the motorhome. So you got good air movement inside of this coach. And then your heat comes from down below. You have vents down below for your heating. Nice shower. Even has a little bit of a tub in there, so it will hold some water. It's not a bathtub that's probably going to be something that an adult's going to spend a lot of time in, but at least it will hold water, and especially if you have little ones that like to go with you, it'd be great for that. The bedroom area has another slide out, what you mentioned, on the outside with some storage underneath. So this lifts up, has access to the underneath the bed, queen size bed with storage on each side of the bed. You do have your nightstands and little drawers or cabinets and on above and below on each side of the bed. Kind of nice to have a window back here too, which again adds a little bit more natural light. If you want to block out that light, you could drop the shade down. Nice, really long cabinet. I guess that's for if you want to hang something in there that's going to be rather long, you can put it in there. More cabinet. Wardrobe capability with plenty of drawers down below. Just have a little TV back here and more storage. Bathroom area has a nice layout. And if you notice, that door will block off, give you some privacy. So when that snaps into place, you open up that, you've got this whole area back in here is blocked off from the front of the motorhome. Got the sink and the toilet and everything right in there. It does have a little slider right here too, so you can actually close this off. So if you do have guests, they can access the bathroom area and you can still have privacy back here. Really great motorhome. If you're looking for something that's on the smaller side, you know, I'd be glad to tell you a little bit more about this one. If you'd come and see me, I'd appreciate it. Maybe give me a call. Again, my name is Jim Beckler, and you can reach me at 541-510-1017. Thanks. Have a great day.